when you sin, that's what you're going to find, the unspotted lamb, and taking it to the precinct, offering it on the sacrifice on the altar as atonement for your sin. You're doing that. Or on the Sabbath day, if you're stoning people for not keeping the Sabbath day, the law commands us to do this. Trying to get you to see
what does the Bible say
about what
to the Gentiles that take the children of Israel into a foreign land. What does the Bible say?
We are Gentiles.
You are.
But what makes you a Jew? Paul said, what makes you a Jew is one inwardly. God wants to circumcise your heart, brother.
He said what makes you a Jew what?
It's one inward. That's gonna make you a Jew now. Yeah.
Oh, anybody?
Do you receive the Spirit of God?
Y'all don't preach by the blood.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, when you repent of your sins, for example, and you accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, and He fill you with His Holy Ghost, that's what makes you a Jew inside of God
spiritually.
That's why I say it's a law of the Spirit, and it's the law of the letter.
Spiritual Israel is what you're saying,
right? It's the spirit of the letter, not by the spirit of the law.
I believe it ain't no coincidence that you're here.
I believe God wanna build on
it. I just wanna hear you preach. That's what I want.
Okay.
It says in Colossians that
I wanna hear you preach.
Don't judge anybody about lipstick.
I haven't judged anybody.
By abstaining from holding it from fasting and observing the days.
Yeah, like you eat pork.
No, by far.
Why? Because the law say don't do that, right? Well, have you read 2 Timothy?
What's it say?
It says, every creature of God is good now, and nothing to be refused or be received.
Yeah, but I'm under the law, brother.
That's what I'm trying to tell you. You're on Mount Sinai. You got to come to the Mount of Olives, man. But Jesus is
not the Mount of Olives.
Okay, well,
Israel.
I'm going to say this one more thing.
It's not the Mount of Olives, Israel.
Have you read when Jesus went to the Mountain of Transfiguration? And Moses made him up there. It was Moses and it was Elijah. And he called Peter and James.
Was the Gentiles there?
I'm going
to
get to that.
Was the Gentiles there? Who was he talking to?
While they was on this mountain of transfiguration, Peter said, look, there go Elijah who represent the prophets. Okay. He said, there go Moses who represent the law.
Was the prophets not all Israelites?
And he said, there go Jesus. You're missing the point, man. He said, there go Jesus. So look, it was Jesus, the Son of God, on this mountain. It was Moses, the law, and it was the prophets. And Peter said, I'm about to build a tabernacle for all y'all to give honor to all of them, you know. And a cloud overshadowed them, though. And God the Father spoke out this cloud. And he said, this is my beloved son, Peter.
Right.
Hear ye him.
Right. The Gentiles
means follow
there?
His teachers.
Was the Gentiles there?
Was that means don't follow Moses.
Was he? Was
don't
he
follow the prophets.
The Gentiles? Who was he speaking to?
Who, Jesus? He was talking to Moses and Elijah on the mountain. Yeah, that's what
was that?
Moses and Elijah. Moses represented the law. Elijah represented the prophet. But God the Father said, hear my son.
Was Moses Israel?
Moses came by the law. Jesus Christ came by grace.
And that's what he was saying, man. Like, listen to my son's teachers now. You don't got to follow Moses no more. He said, follow my son, man. And that's all I'm trying to explain. You know,
that's right, that's right.
But, man, I love you, bro.
I love you too.
I'm glad you're out here. You know, I'm glad I met you. I don't think it's no coincidence. Man, I don't believe in those. But I hope, you know, if that's your truth, man, and man, you feel like that's going to get you into heaven, I hope that Jesus confirmed it. And if it's not the truth, I hope he shows you the truth. We can go back and forth all day.